This project is already split in some virtual folders that will get us thinking about the model, view, and controller. The app delegate and the GCD black box have been placed outside of these folders, and we can ignore them for now. In the model folder, we have this clients folder, and then under clients, we have TMDB for the movie database. This folder structure represents the idea that we could have multiple clients or managers that handle all the code related to an API. But since we're only working with the movie database, we just have this single TMDB folder. But you could imagine others, like one for Flickr or Facebook or so forth. Now in the TMDB folder, we have Swift files that pertain to the main model of our project, the TMDB movie, as well as the API's config, constants, and a TMDB client that will handle all the communications with the API itself. We'll talk about this more later. You'll also notice there's this one controller-like file called TMDB auth view controller. We've designated this file as part of the model instead of the controller because it's used specifically for the movie database's auth flow and nowhere else. But that was just our design decision. It doesn't have to be this way. If we look inside the TMDB client file, we see that the client is only partially implemented. These two methods here are still commented out. Here at the top, we've moved the authentication state into this class instead of it being in the app delegate like it was in My Favorite Movies. And if we scroll to the bottom, we have some helper methods. And at the very bottom, we have a method that allows us to use this client like a singleton, so in a very similar way as to how we use the app delegate in My Favorite Movies. Now these two empty methods at the top, called taskForget method and taskForPost method, the purpose of these methods is to reduce the common code in our request. And you've probably noticed that there's a lot of common code between each network request that we've been making. We also have this TMDB convenience.swift file, which you'll be adding code to as well. Now let's look at the view. It contains a single file called borderedButton.swift. Now some of you may be thinking, what gives? Shouldn't this folder contain our storyboards and media files, since they are what the user sees? They are the view. Well, you could do it that way, and it's really up to you, but we've decided to keep our MVC folder split in organization where we're just focusing on the Swift files and not the other associated media files. Our reasoning for this is because most of the actual view classes have already been built by Apple and are packaged together inside of UIKit. And in that way, we've decided that this view folder over here should only contain custom code of ours that is purely view related. So in this case, the only custom UI code that we have is this bordered button. Finally, let's talk about the controllers. This folder contains classes that touch a little bit of the view and a little bit of our model. I'll start with the login view controller. This class is a prime candidate for why our previous app, My Favorite Movies, was so poorly designed. In this controller, we have four methods for the four different steps that are required for the movie database's authorization flow. And you'll note that the login with token uses the new step 2A, which we're going to cover more detail later. But we have the get request token, and then login with token, which is step 2, get session ID, and then the user ID isn't really part of the authorization flow, but we get the user ID ahead of time so that we can use it in requests like adding and removing movies from favorites. Now each of these methods, let me blow one of them out right here. Each of these methods has a lot of duplicate code, and they make this controller a really big and heavy class. I think, let's see, we're at 340 lines right now, so it's starting to get pretty large. But what's worse is that if we want to add more complexity, this controller is just going to keep growing and growing and become really hard to deal with. And when you have big files like this and lots of duplicate code, then you know you have problems. What we should be thinking about is how can we make our code light, clean, and reusable, not overly complex and hard to manage. For our apps, a great way to fix this problem is to always keep our view controllers small by migrating the logic like this networking code, away into the model. So for this application, we're going to take the code that's in this login view controller and move it into the model, or into the movie database client, this TMDB client.